Ghana School of Law can and should be offered by the universities approved by the council. In my mind, the universities with their interdisciplinary approach and emphasis on research are better equipped to teach these courses than the Ghana School of Law. The Ghana School of Law has no comparative advantage whatsoever in teaching these courses. Equally important, because they have this bifurcated model, the sequencing of course is so out of whack that civil procedure that you need to understand before you can really enjoy reading law cases is taught when you go to the School of Law. So you can get your LLB without ever taking a course in civil procedure or criminal procedure or evidence. This is just a bizarre way of learning law. This illogical sequencing exists largely, if not solely, because of the maintained but superfluous distinction between academic and professional education. Second, the distinction amplifies the myth that there are discontinuities in academic and professional legal education, with the former being theoretical and the latter being practical in outlook. In fact, the two cannot be meaningfully disentangled without impoverishing both. Legal education in all its facets should train lawyers how to think. It should never train lawyers how to draft stuff. So I saw an exam question from the qualifying thing that they do at the School of Law. One of the things they asked was, draft a writ of summons. I'm like, what the heck is that? I will never pass such an exam. Why should I waste my time to learn how to draft a writ of summons when I can go and look at it in some form? It doesn't show anything. It doesn't prove anything. It doesn't prove like that you can think like a lawyer at all. It's just a waste of your mind. Students must not just be expected to learn the positive law, but they must be allowed to explore the law as a transformative tool. In this regard, legal education must not be evaluated in terms of how well it serves the expectation of the judiciary, you know, whether you know how to file an affidavit, but rather how it contributes to a jurisprudence that facilitates the legal, economic, social, and political transformation of the country. This transformative training, in my mind, can be better offered by the law faculties, whose core mission is to train well-rounded lawyers and others. On the other hand, so-called professional education at the Ghana School of Law focuses too much on positive law and meeting the expectations of the judiciary. The erratic and frequent shifts in the duration of the professional program from 2 years to 1 year, it just tells you that the program is being administered by people who are not educators. They are very good, they may be very good judges, they may be very good lawyers, but being a judge or being a good lawyer doesn't make you a good educator. When it comes to education, let the educators do it. We learned specialization from Adam Smith. How many minutes do I have, Nick?
You have 5 minutes.
5 minutes, okay. All right. The current bifurcated model leads to the unusual situation where passing the professional courses offered at the School of Law becomes the basis for the ultimate enrollment at the bar. I want someone to be called to the bar because they've demonstrated competence in constitutional law and contracts and thought and so on and so forth, not because they can pass an accounting examination which is offered at the School of Law. Or here's a question that I stole from the School of Law Practice Management exam. In three very short paragraphs, outline three of the theories of management that has evolved since Frederick Taylor, and then they give you the date, propounded his management theory. Why is a lawyer being tested on this as a basis for his being called to the bar? And this, my friend, can only happen because the program is in the hands of the wrong people. Let me move on.